I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today is a day to be thankful. Thankful that millions of men and women answer our nation's call to duty, to protect our shores and our cherished freedoms. We ask that God watch over our veterans and their families and grant them solace and strength. We ask that God bless our nation with its sacred dedication to freedom and equality. We pray that God guard and protect all of those in uniform today and our future veterans who are risking their lives to protect us. And we ask for God's blessings on our Long Island State Veterans Home, its residents, its staff, its volunteers, the families of our residents, and our entire university, our elected officials, and our community, on this sacred day of honoring those for whom honor is so richly deserved.
Hello and welcome to all our veterans at the Long Island State Veterans Home. I am Fred Sganga, the Executive Director of the Home, and I'd like to welcome you to our virtual ceremony today for Veterans Day. Today we honor more than 56 million Americans who proudly wore the uniform on behalf of a grateful nation. We all know the awesome burdens our young men and women bear in America's fight against terrorism and tyranny. Their sacrifices on far-flung battlefields and their selfless service in the name of peace reinforce daily the resolve of all of us to cherish those willing patriots who have answered freedom's call. Do you enjoy peace and freedom? Do you live in a society based on laws of, by, and for the people? Do you vote freely and for those who govern at all levels? Do you enjoy the freedom to protest peacefully without retribution? Do you enjoy the freedom to practice your religion without reprisal? If you live in this country, if you are an American citizen, you do. And you owe all that and more to the men and women your fellow citizens of today and yesterday, who have served in the armed forces of the United States of America. That service is the price of freedom and strength of our nation. The price paid by our veterans is very real as life lost, as real as horror endured, as a body torn and disabled. Those who pay the price pay it on behalf of all of us, and countless thousands continue paying for it long after their military service ends. American fighting men and women are now engaged in a war on terrorism for which our nation has already paid a terrible price in lives lost. Today, let us rededicate ourselves to honor America's 21 million living veterans. They earn the best we can offer from our hearts and from our service. Please join the Long Island State Veterans Home on this Veterans Day in a pledge to keep the spirit of Americans' veterans alive and the banner for which they served flying high as the chimes of freedom ring across our great land. And while today's Veterans Day feels different because of our battle against the novel coronavirus, better known as COVID-19, please know that all of us, all 675 employees at the Long Island State Veterans Home, remain focused on our mission to take care of Americans' heroes. Thanks to all our veterans for your selfless service to our country. We are glad you can join us today for our virtual Veterans Day ceremony. We hope you will enjoy today's ceremony. God bless you, and God bless America.
Hello, I'm Maurie McInnis, president of Stony Brook University. Although many things feel different this year, everything from how we connect with friends and family to how we commemorate this Veterans Day, some things remain the same. Hope, respect, community, and especially today, gratitude. All of us at Stony Brook University salute our veterans. Thank you for your service and sacrifice. Since the Long Island State Veterans Home opened its doors on Stony Brook University's campus in October of 1991, we have had the honor of serving over 10,000 veterans and their families. It has been almost 30 years of this profound connection, and I couldn't be prouder. Whether you served in the Army, Navy, Marine Corps, Air Force, or Coast Guard, thank you for protecting the freedoms we enjoy today. And thank you for being a part of the fabric of our university. Thank you for helping us build and preserve the sense of community and respect that I love about Stony Brook. We are committed to helping our veteran students make the most of their education with admissions counseling, financial aid, advising, our very active Veteran Students Organization, and more. We are committed to all of those veterans who reside at the home. One of the most difficult parts of assuming my role as president at the start of the COVID-19 pandemic has been the inability to visit our revered spaces and meet the people that make this community special. I so look forward to meeting all of you as soon as I can, so I can tell you, in person, how much the Long Island State Veterans Home means to Stony Brook. In this year of challenges and change, the reverence and gratitude we have for you persist and are as strong as ever. I hope you enjoy this Veterans Day holiday. Thank you for your sacrifice and service. Thank you for protecting our freedoms and keeping us safe.
It is with great pleasure that I join you today, unfortunately virtually, to honor Veterans Day and all of you who call the Long Island State Veterans Home home. And while I'm at it, let me provide a shout out of profound thanks to all the nurses, physicians, medical aid, social workers, dietary, housekeeping staff, in short, all of the people who make the Long Island State Veterans Home so special. All of us at Stony Brook Medicine continue to be proud of our commitment to all of you, whose military service protected the freedoms and democracy we all enjoy today. Whether you served in World War II, in Korea, Vietnam, or the Gulf Wars, or in between during peacetime, we thank you for your service to our democracy, which seems to be always under threat. Today, when you look around the Long Island State Veterans Home, you can clearly witness our commitment to those who have worn the uniform. As the governing body for the Long Island State Vet Home, it has been my great privilege to see Operation Rejuvenation in full stride and progressing towards completion. This project represents the university's strong desire to always maintain a state-of-the-art facility that any veteran would be proud to call home. This over $20 million project will ensure that all veterans, from the greatest generation to the latest generation, will be well cared for years to come. But the home is much more than just the building. It's really all about the people. It seems strange, but we're now fighting another war, not with guns and bombs, but with masks and gloves, COVID-19. All of you in this building have again risen to the COVID challenge in keeping people safe to enjoy their freedoms. In closing, let me say that it is truly humbling for me to be sharing some time with our heroes on this very special day. Let me reaffirm my commitment to all veterans from all conflicts that the Long Island State Veterans Home at Stony Brook University, we will always be there for you. Thank you once again to all of those here today. Have a great, great Veterans Day. Thank you.
Good day, Joe Rowan. I'm honored to serve as the resident council president here at the Long Island State Veterans Home. Special recognition this Veterans Day to our Gold Star families that are unable to observe the holiday in the same context that we do. As a Vietnam veteran, when we returned, we were not recognized in a proper manner. This spring, the doctors, nurses, and CNAs here did an extraordinary job with the virus. I contracted the virus, as did my aide, and we had substitute aides each day. My first concern was whether anybody was going to show up. They did show up, and each of the substitutes were more professional and kinder than the one the day before. We're very grateful to the nurses, the doctors, and especially the CNAs that allow me to be here to observe another Veterans Day. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Bob Smith. I'm the chairman of the Veterans Advisory Board here at the Long Island State Veterans Home in Stony Brook. On behalf of all the veterans on the Veterans Advisory Board, we'd like to wish our veterans a happy Veterans Day. Thank you for serving in the United States Armed Forces. May God bless you, your family, your friends, and may God bless America. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Congresswoman Kathleen Rice. Every year on Veterans Day, we come together to thank and honor the veterans who served our nation. It is because of your service and sacrifice that we can live freely in our country today. But this year, of course, is very different. I know it has been an incredibly difficult time at the Long Island State Veterans Home. COVID-19 has taken so many lives and caused tragedy for so many families. And your community has been one of the hardest hit in the state. It has been absolutely heartbreaking. To the employees, the staff, medical professionals, thank you. Your work during this crisis has been invaluable, and we could not get through it without you. But as this pandemic continues, we as public officials need to do everything that we can to keep our veterans safe. In Congress, I'm fighting for more relief funding to ensure VA facilities, hospitals, and veterans' homes have the support they need to get through this crisis. I joined our Long Island delegation in sending a bipartisan letter to House leadership urging them to include additional economic assistance to state veterans' homes specifically.
And as a member of the House Veterans Affairs Committee, I am working on a number of important issues, including addressing mental health, combating high suicide rates, and providing support for caretakers. I'll never stop working for our nation's veterans and will always support all of you at the Long Island State Veterans Home. You served our country with dignity and honor. You were there for us when we needed you. And I promise you, we are here for you now. Thank you.
Today, as we pause to remember Veterans Day, to reflect upon those veterans that made a sacrifice for our country, I give a special recognition to my friends on Long Island at the New York State Veterans Home. Thank you so much for your service. On Veterans Day, we remember those veterans that served in battles that we won and in battles that we lost. Soldiers that carried a rifle in combat and those that served in, as a mechanic or on KP duty. We recognize every single soldier and sailor and airman that served our nation, whether they went across the oceans or that they served here at home. We thank all of our veterans. Today, I'd like to make a special recognition of those veterans that sustained injuries, whether they're visible injuries that we all see or injuries that they carry with themselves alone at night in the dark. Every single veteran made a sacrifice. We thank you for everything you did. And we thank the New York State Veterans Home here on Long Island for the service that they provide, the miracles that they bring into veterans' home. They deserve the recognition, the health care, both physical and mental, to help them live out their later years. Thank you all for your service. God bless every single one of you. Happy Veterans Day to every single veteran that served our nation. Thank you, and God bless you all.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul. I'm very proud to recognize Veterans Day with the Long Island State Veterans Home family and to celebrate your 29th anniversary. Our governor's father, Mario Cuomo, literally cut the ribbon to open the Veterans Home back on October 21st, 1991, and was the driving force in establishing this home 3 decades ago. It's amazing that since that time, the Veterans Home has assisted over 10,000 veterans and their families. We also want to recognize 3 outstanding individuals today. James Carboni, the United States from the United States Air Corps, World War II. Biagio Inamortata, United States Army, Korean War. Al Anderson, United States Army, Vietnam. Each of you answered the call to protect our country and keep us safe, and we will never forget that. I want to thank all of you who served at various times in our history and the families who joined virtually today. As we mark the annual observance of Veterans Day, we are called to reflect upon what a grateful nation owes you, our veterans, in return for your sacrifices. First, you deserve world-class health care, and second, the dignity of a good home. Meeting those needs is personal for me. As a member of the House Armed Services Committee, I fought to ensure our veterans receive whatever care and support they needed. I had 4 uncles serve during the Vietnam conflict, and each wore a uniform when it was not popular to do so. And sadly, neither they nor others who served at that time ever received the hero's welcome home they deserved. And I was also very proud of my father-in-law, Bill Hochul, who during World War II was part of the invasion that landed on Omaha Beach 2 months after D-Day. He was part of a tank battalion that led the campaign across Europe, liberating people. And like so many who served during World War II and other conflicts, he never spoke of his service. After he passed, we found a map that showed his campaign from England to France and across Europe, a living memory of his service. Like him, many of you have kept your stories to yourselves, and I respect that. But you need to know that on behalf of Governor Cuomo, myself, and 20 million New Yorkers, we take this day and every day to tell you how grateful we are for what you did to preserve our democracy and our cherished freedoms. We remember what you fought for, the values of freedom, honor, and integrity, and everything that has made our nation the greatest on earth. For that, we thank you. Happy Veterans Day.
Hi, this is State Controller Tom DiNapoli. I'd like to thank my good friend, your executive director, Fred Sganga, along with the great staff at the Long Island State Veterans Home, for creating one of Long Island's best providers of long-term skilled nursing services and adult day health care, offering compassionate care for thousands of our veterans. Veterans Day serves as a reminder that our democracy and the freedoms we enjoy were protected and continue to be preserved by the courage and sacrifice of countless men and women who have helped defend liberty around the world. Today, we remember and give thanks. On Veterans Day, we recall and affirm our ability as a nation to come together, especially in the most difficult and dangerous of circumstances, to rise above our differences and do what is right and what is needed. While Veterans Days come just once a year, at Long Island State Veterans Home, high-quality care is delivered with respect and dignity on a daily basis. That's the way it should be. As former President Barack Obama once said, it's about how we treat our veterans every single day of the year. It's about making sure they have the care they need and the benefits that they've earned when they come home. It's about serving all of you as well as you serve the United States of America. From the soldiers who served in World War II, to the men and women still serving in places like Afghanistan, Iraq, and Korea, we must strive to take care of America's veterans as well as they've taken care of us. You and countless other veterans from all walks of life have earned our nation's lasting gratitude. Thank you for your service. God bless our veterans, and God bless America.
State Senator Ken LaValle reaching out to honor our veterans who have served and sacrificed for their country. These are difficult times, and our traditional celebrations have changed. Even though I'm speaking to you today by video, the gratitude we feel for your courageous and dedicated service remains unchanged. Today and every day, we honor and celebrate all veterans across the country. Thank you for the sacrifices you and your families have made. God bless you all, and God bless this great nation.
On the 11th day in the 11th month, at the 11th hour, we pause as a nation each year to celebrate and honor all American veterans for their patriotism, love of country, and willingness to serve and sacrifice for the common good. It's very much a celebration of all of you and all those great Americans throughout our long history who have stepped forward in times of need to preserve, protect, and defend our nation. It's because of all of you and those who came before you that the flag flies freely outside your building. Because of all of you, we can vote freely for our choice of who leads this nation and who represents us in the various levels of government. Because of you and the grace of God, our nation will continue to be that great city on the hill that serves as the light of hope for all the world. This is State Senator John Brooks, Chairman of the Veterans Committee in the New York State Senate, thanking all of you for your service. May God bless you, your family, and our nation. Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Suffolk County Executive Steve Ballone. First and foremost, I want to thank all of you at the Long Island State Veterans Home for the opportunity to deliver a virtual message on this Veterans Day. And of course, to thank all of you for your service to our country. Like most things in 2020, our Veterans Day celebrations look different this year. We have all, together, weathered the storm of the coronavirus outbreak in Suffolk County and are now battling the ongoing public health and fiscal crisis. None of you are strangers to crisis, to challenging situations or overcoming obstacles. In the past 8 months, no one embodies New York tough more than our veterans. With the largest veterans population in New York State, it is vital that today and every day we honor and appreciate our veterans. I'm proud to say that in Suffolk County, we do just that. Just last month, we adapted our annual Catholic Health Services Suffolk County Marathon to a month-long virtual race to ensure that we continue enhancing our services and programs for the well-being of our veterans, even as we continue to navigate these unprecedented times. In closing, it's an honor, as both a fellow veteran and as your county executive, to be serving each and every one of you. Again, thank you for your selfless bravery, and happy Veterans Day.
Hello, I am Suffolk County Legislator Kara Hahn, and I would like to send a special thank you and hello to all my friends at the Long Island State Veterans Home. I'm so sorry that I cannot be there today, and I ordinarily would be, but I want to make sure you know that our community thanks you and sends its love and its best wishes to you and your families. Thank you for all you have done to protect our community and this great nation.
Hi, I'm Suffolk County Legislator Susan Burland, and I'm the chairwoman of the legislature's Veterans and Consumer Affairs Committee. I wish I could be there with all of you today. Everyone at the Long Island State Veterans Home has been working so hard during this pandemic. We're so lucky to have Fred at the helm, and I want to thank everyone for putting together this virtual ceremony for Veterans Day. I know these past few months have been challenging, and that Veterans Day looks very different this year, but I hope you all know how grateful Suffolk County is for your service. It is my privilege to work for and work with our county's veterans to help them navigate the challenges they face. We owe you all such a debt of gratitude, and we're here to help in any way we can. So today and every day, for all that you have done, we say thank you. Thank you for your service. Thank you for ensuring our freedoms. And thank you to your families for their sacrifice. Although we can't be together this Veterans Day, I am with you in heart and spirit. I hope to see you all soon. Please stay healthy and safe. Bye-bye.
Hi, I'm Captain Anthony Sasawi. I have a poem I want to read you. It's called The Veteran. When you see someone in a uniform, someone who serves us all, doing military duty, answering their country's call, take a moment to thank them for protecting what you hold dear, and then you are proud of them. Make it very clear. Just tap them on the shoulder, give them a smile, and say thanks for what you're doing to keep me as safe as the USA.
Hi, my name is Alex, and I just want to say thank you for protecting our country and giving us freedom, and I hope you all have a happy Veterans Day.
Hi, my name is Kyle. I'd like to thank all the veterans of the Long Island State Veterans Home for your service. I wrote a card today and I'd like to read it now. Thank you for all that you do. All the sacrifices you made to keep all of us safe. All the risks you had to take and the lives you all saved. Once again, I'd like to thank you for your service and have a happy Veterans Day.
I would like to thank our veterans for fighting for our country every single day and risking their lives so that we could live ours and allowing us to be safe and happy.
I would like to say thank you for your hard work and dedication. It doesn't go unnoticed, and you're the reason why our country is as great as it is.
Thank you to all the veterans who served and made the ultimate sacrifice and put their lives on the line for our freedoms. Thank you.
Thank you for serving our country, and shout out to my grandpa.
I just want to say thank you for your heroic service and courageous attitude every day, no matter where you are serving the country. You mean a lot to all of us, and you really do make a difference, and thank you always.
I'd like to say thank you. Thank you for your service. Thank you for all you do, and my dad was a veteran, so it's a particularly meaningful day to me, and I really would like to acknowledge that our country is taken care of by these people, and we appreciate it.
I want to say thank you to all the veterans for helping us and defending the country and sacrificing your rights.
Veterans are the reason we have freedom, and they have fought and died for this country, so thank you for your service, thank you for everything that you do for us, and you're the reason we're still working. So,
thank you for everything you've done for our country.
Thank you. So I have two uncles that served in Vietnam. I had a grandfather that served in World War II. And I always make it a point to make sure that I call them and just say thank you for your service. I think it's a small thing that you can do, but it's something that they certainly appreciate. A lot of veterans, they're not looking for, any type of major attention, but I think what they do look for is the acknowledgement that they, they put their lives on the line, and I think it's important for us to acknowledge that.
I'd like to thank them for their service and making sure we're all safe in this wonderful country.
Hi, thank you to all veterans for putting your lives on the line for our country and for upholding our values in the United States.
Certainly, I'd like to let them know that we appreciate their service. We hope they're well and they get everything that they need.
I would like to thank veterans for their selfless service and for being our everyday heroes. Thank you for your service.
Thank you for everything. You're the entire reason that America can be what it is and how it's so great. So, thank you.
Thank you so much for your service. I'm so grateful for all that you've done. You are so brave. You are my hero. Happy Veterans Day.
Thank you, veterans. Thank you for all that you have done. I'm so grateful. I hope you stay safe and healthy.
Happy Veterans Day!
Hi everyone at the Long Island State Veterans Home. My name is Jonathan Romano. I'm a veteran of the Army National Guard and the Deputy Grand Knight at St. Jude Council, Knights of Columbus in Rocky Point. And we just wanted to send you guys our support and show you our council. We have our American flag, which was installed by the Squires here right around September 11th in 2001. And we have our sign up here to support our veterans. So we want to thank everybody at the Long Island State Veterans Home. We're not far from you over in Rocky Point here. And we miss seeing you guys every month when you had your monthly meeting with the Knights of Columbus. We can't wait to be able to get back there to see you guys, and our own Father Tom, who does Mass at the Veterans Home too, is our chaplain here at the St. Jude Knights of Columbus. So we're sending you your support. Thank you for your service. Take care.
Thank you so much for your service to our country. I will forever be grateful and will be appreciative.
Thank you to those who have served and who continue to serve.
Thank you so much for your service and the sacrifices you've made for this country. I appreciate the freedoms that you fought for.
Happy Veterans Day. We are deeply grateful for your service to our country. Thank you so much for protecting our liberties.
Those who continue to serve and those who have served in the past, thank you for your service to our country and for ensuring the freedoms that we enjoy every day.
Who have served and continue to serve. Happy Veterans.
Happy Veterans Day.
For all the hard work and dedication for our country. JFK Middle School thanks you.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, you'd worked for all your life, and you had to start again with just your children and your wife. You'd thank your lucky stars to be living here today. 'Cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me. And I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Let us pray as we share our benediction. Almighty and everlasting Father, we have gathered here today to look back and remember, to remember those who made the ultimate sacrifice in defense of this nation, in the defense of right over wrong. We remember that there is more that unites us than separates us. And to believe, and we do believe, that light can overcome darkness and brokenness can be healed. Today on this Veterans Day, we have come to remember the sacrifice, courage, and faith of those who made the supreme sacrifice. But not only them, but those who endured the hardships and the tragedies of war. We remember their sacrifice on this day. We also remember their courage, that they go forward in faith, and that they went forward in faith. We also remember the faith they had in the Almighty, who was with them then, who's with them now, and forevermore. So we have come to remember, we have come to give thanks, for in all things we give thanks. Lord, we thank you for allowing us to come together this day on Veterans Day. Amen, amen. Amen.